Hello, hello, everybody, and welcome back to Krimzon Plays Assassin's Creed. Before we get... Oop, wrong button. I want this button. Before we get properly started, just a second while I readjust where my microphone is, because I had to move my camera and stuff. Before we get properly started, I do need to quickly address some things. There is SAG-AFTRA, the Screen Actors Guild, have announced that they have voted to... I forget the exact verbiage. Basically, they voted to prepare for a strike to strike on the in the video game industry. You can check them check out their page for more information. But basically, there's a group like with the WGA strike and the SAG-AFTRA strike for the TV, film, and media. They're preparing to extend that also to video games, for the video game stuff at some point. excuse me. What this means for streamers on Twitch and stuff, no idea. At this point, because they have not officially declared a strike yet. They're basically just saying, if we have, if these companies do not negotiate with us, properly, then we will strike, type of a thing. So currently nothing has to change or anything, but, I am preparing, and other streamers should be preparing, especially video game, specifically video game streamers and YouTubers and content creators, should be preparing for the potentiality of having to, well, put it bluntly, not stream, at least not stream certain video games. The companies that they are, my allergies are in full swing today, and you guys should know, like, you probably already know how bad my allergies are on a given stream day. But what am I looking for? I'm looking for the SAG-AFTRA link. There it is. I had it. Anyway, I just couldn't find it. But the companies that they are, that this would be applying to, is Activision Productions Inc., Blind Light LLC, Disney Character Voices Inc., Electronic Arts Productions Inc., Epic Games Inc., Formosa Interactive LLC, Insomniac Games Inc., Take-Two Productions Inc., Voice Work Productions Inc., and WB Games Inc. What this means is, if they strike, all properties that are a part of, produced by subdivisions of those companies, will be considered struck. And so that means, like, COD and, like, Call of Duty, specifically, like, especially Warzone. I think Fortnite's on that list. Basically, there's a bunch of games that are on this, that are connected to these companies that would be considered struck material. That includes, as for me specifically, that includes Assassin's Creed Syndicate, I believe. I did a bunch of research over the weekend, excuse me, into this, and one of the games on the list for one of these companies, I believe it was blind light, I don't remember for sure, is Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Now, I will say, in general, unless SAG says... all of this is hypothesis, right? Because hypotheticals, because they have not yet, SAG has not yet declared a strike, right? And because they have not yet declared a strike, they have not yet released any specific requirements or requests for what would be considered crossing the picket line. And so there's a lot of discourse right now, especially on like places like TikTok and stuff, about hypotheticals about what that would mean for the streaming, Twitch streaming and YouTube and TikTok and all of that, as far as video game content creation. And basically the long and short of it is we don't know yet, right? We don't know because they haven't said. And what a lot of people, what I and a lot of other people have been doing is we're basing what we're expecting. If this happens, we're basing what we're expecting to be off of the ongoing WGA SAG film and TV media strikes. And that is that no promotion of struck material, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And that means no, that would mean most likely, well, rephrasing, finishing the initial thought, no promotion of struck material, either paid for or organically. In other words, if somebody came in here and was like, hey, what do you think about such and such? I can't talk about it. Like, hey, there's this awesome new show on a certain streaming network out there. Have you seen it? What do you think? Can't talk about it. It's one of the things I've been trying very hard to do because to be respectful of and cognizant of while streaming is not talking about things that would count as organically, that would count as talking about struck material. I probably have failed that along the, at some point, just because I don't always think before I speak. It's a thing I'm working on. But I'm trying my best. As for how this would hypothetically apply to streaming, it all depends on if they count video game streaming as promoting struck content. Most likely they would, because that's what I consider it as. It just makes sense to me, you know? One of the things I do when I'm looking at whether or not I want to play a video game is check out what streamers are playing it and being like, oh, how does the gameplay look? That, you know? It makes sense, you know? But it depends, and it doesn't matter what I think, it matters what SAG thinks, because they'd be the ones doing the striking. Yeah, okay, sorry, I cleared off my desk by moving my notebook over there, and it's not fully on where I tossed it. Anyway. And point is, there may come a time over the next month or so where I may have to stop streaming or may have to drastically change my streaming schedule, putting certain games on hold, namely Tomb Raider. Because the three remaining Tomb Raider games, the one I'm on and the two after it, excuse me, are all struck content, would all be struck content. ReCore would be struck content. Watch foreign companies, probably not. So like Japanese made video games, maybe, most likely not. and some Ubisoft games, maybe not. Which is why only Assassin's Creed Syndicate and the Chronicles trilogy, from what I recall, are on the lists. But I could be wrong about that. I don't know. We'll see. This is all conjecture and hypotheticals. Bernie Sanders lost his shirt. Oh, well, it's fine. I'll swap over to Yvonne. Anyway, point is, again, be aware that moving forward, streamers will need to be a bit careful what content we put out, or at least be prepared to, sorry, there's a bug that I'm trying to grab. It's fine. Or at least be prepared to stop streaming for a while. Certain indie games may be fine in the same way that a lot of indie movies and are not considered struck content for the WGA SAG strike. But again, it heavily depends on what SAG itself says. So, yeah. Anyway. I am playing it by ear going forward. I am prepared to stop streaming. I'm hoping I don't have to, because this is my job. But if I do have to stop streaming, or at least stop streaming video games, I do have other things that I can do, because I could probably do like tabletop games. I could do other things. Probably won't be as popular other things, but who knows? We'll see. We'll see. Like I said, I'm playing it all by ear, seeing what happens, because this may all be unnecessary to think about, you know? Yeah. We'll see. Anyway. I need to finish what I was looking for. There we go. There we go. Okay. All right. So back to this, which should be popping up right here in a second. There we go. As I die, excuse me, everybody. God damn. Ugh. Anyway, before we get properly into this, I'm just going to run in and grab my money because I forgot to do that. Before we get properly started, in the meantime, we're going to continue as if nothing has changed. And so that means I have a link tree. If you want to continue to see my content, unless or until a strike is called by SAG-AFTRA, or some other group for that matter, feel free to check out my link tree, to follow my socials for updates, my Discord for updates, or... God, I'm so sorry, everybody. Or join my Patreon, where you can support me and help me out and make sure that this channel continues to be awesome. In the meantime, of whatever else out there, yeah. Anyway. And we'll get back to this now. Okay. Just because I've officially run out of things to say. And I'm feeling like if anything else, I'll just end up coughing a lot, or end up, just repeating myself at this point. So we're moving on. We were going to try to quickly wrap up the last few of these murder mysteries here. All right. Let us do hot chocolate to die for. Cause that sounds good. That is in. Up here. Somewhere.
Have a good day, sir.
Oh, wait. I did remember something I wanted to do before actually getting stuck into this. Hey, man.
I am at your service, monsieur.
I just want to quickly check to make sure I haven't missed any of these. Nope. Okay. And I wanted to... Here we go. This one's my room. That's the study. This is my room. Do I have any letters from Elise? No.
I hope I know what I'm doing.
Okay. Tell everybody. Nope.
Paris s'enflamme pour la révolution. Le peuple se révolte. Les tout derniers développements sont uniquement dans la gazette.
I want the money right now.
You do not assault people. I assault people. In fact, I don't assault people, I pepper people. It wasn't assault, it was a pepper. I'm sorry. I'm not, but I am. Oh, wee. Ho ho ho. Hey, wee. Pop on me. There it is. Oh no! Oh! Bless. Women's body. Woman, Valerie Duclos, probably. Valerie Duclos, in her 40s, extremely well-dressed and in the old fashion of the monarchy, face contorted into a horrible expression, no indication of physical violence. An overturned cup. A porcelain cup with a Japanese style. Come on. Design appears to have held hot chocolate. Okay. Talk to
what
the witness.
What are you doing here? This is a private tragedy. If you must know, I am Amélie Mauvoisin. This is... was... my elder sister, Valerie Duclos. I refuse to believe that Georges poisoned her, even after what she said. Valerie and I were quite close, but I must say, she was simply dreadful the entire evening, drinking too much, insulting everyone. The worst was when she announced she planned to denounce Georges to the Committee of Public Safety.
Well... Hmm. A maintained garden with various flowers, foxgloves, belladonna, and others that are fatal when ingested. Ma'am, did you know, are you aware of the fact that you've got a bunch of fatal plants over here? Let's see here, what else we got? Anything up here? One, two, three, four. I am missing a thing. Ah! It blended in. A ring! A woman's ring discarded in shrubbery. Upon close inspection, one pearl is revealed to be a removable stopper for a tiny hidden vial. The vial is empty, save for a drop of a sticky, clear, odorless liquid. Well, so most likely this was done by a woman. And as you're the only woman that's not dead, I could just accuse you, but no, we've got like five other things to check. So, four other locations. Well, let's try inside. Anything in here? No. Sorry. How about over here? Yep. What is that? Ah, La Patriot. Maybe upstairs? Nope. Right over here. Yep. How about over here? Oh, okay. I'm a bit confused then. Da 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 da. Okay. We're going to go into. No. Wrong thing. Database. Case files. Hot chocolate to die for. Belladonna. Porcelain cup. Garden ring. Zoles. Zoles. It only takes me to here. Okay. And a woman's body. I mean, I want to go make, oh, here we go. This is the house. Okay. Kitchen supplies. A large earthenware jug remains of a thick cocoa paste. Also a jar containing finely milled cocoa powder along with empty milk jug and urn of sugar. And you. a large stoneware pestle and mortar used for crushing herbs in the garden.
Used to come by for meals and eat and eat. Pity he'll be getting the chop. But madame, spit her day lording it over poor Miss Amelie and yelling at Master Pierre. Who knows what Miss will do now, not having a penny to her name and not likely to find a husband at her age.
Yeah, but I didn't hear what you said.
Spit her day lord.
Elderly maid did not care for the victim, but remembers victim's husband fondly. Vouches for George's character and underscored that the victim... Sorry, one second. Excuse me. And underscored that the victim often lorded it over Pierre and Amelie. Amelie. Claimed that Amelie hasn't a penny to her name.
Get over poor Miss Amelie and yelling at Master Pierre. Who knows what
Okay. Do we have another location at this moment? No? Is there an upstairs here, possibly? Yes. Book, Paris Society. Notable events in Paris Society, volume 11. Yeah, 11. A page is marked detailing La Voisine, poisonings of the previous century. It seems one Catherine de Chez Lavoisine and her daughter Marguerite Monvoisine were involved. Monvoisine. Documents. Go away, database entries. The safe contains an ancient document Oh my god. The safe contains an ancient document has been thrown loosely on top of many others. My mother, through her business, amassed a considerable personal fortune before her death, which she left entirely to me, her eldest daughter. To honor her, I declare a legacy to be passed to the eldest surviving female of my line, born of the name Monvoisine. My wealth is held in trust, with the income benefiting my heir directly. As one heir dies, it passes to her eldest daughter, or if none, her eldest sister, or if none, her eldest female relation. In addition, the heir must take ownership of my mother's commonplace book and her collection of glass rings and necklaces, the judicious use of which is essential to the success of the enterprise. Indeed, what these items represent is more powerful than any wealth. I declare these to be my wishes upon my death. Marguerite Monvoisine, Belle Ile en Mer, 1692. An old book bearing the name La Voisine on the inside cover. A marked passage reads, I obtained this recipe from a close friend who in turn obtained it from a relation, whom is reputed to have received it from a certain Italian gentleman, proving its authenticity. It produces a liquid devoid of color, smell, or taste that demonstrates the desired result within mere minutes. Many have sought the secret I am about to divulge, guard it well. The passage continues with an involved process in which arsenic, belladonna leaves, and lead powder are reduced to form a clear, odorless liquid. There are marginal notes made in several hands in faded ink. Interesting. And there was something over here. A crumpled letter found on the floor. It appears to be a legal firm. Dear Madame Duclos, I myself was witness to the signing of your late husband's last will and testament only a few months before his death. He left the sum to be managed by his friend George. I'm not even going to try that one. With the bulk of the estate to go to your son, Pierre. He discussed the matter over cognac, and he seemed most reasonable. Madam, I would thank you to not call into question my thoroughness and professionalism. Neither your husband nor Monsieur disclose the document you have brought to light. I prefer to think they were unaware of its existence. Regardless, the document appears to be genuine and gives you an undisputable claim to the assets. There is, however, one obstacle to your stated desire to take immediate and direct control of the inheritance. The law dictates that women may not manage their own financial affairs. Therefore, Monsieur Georges blah, 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 continues to hold complete authority over the entire fortune, despite the fact that the assets have always belonged directly to you and never to your husband. As long as is active, your husband's will dictates that he, and not yourself, stands as the one who controls the fortune. Please accept my most sincere regards and esteem, Maxime Sequoitier is probably what it is. Okay, that's three places. Oh, and a new place.
Sorry, Pierre.
She was difficult, Georges, but she was my mother.
I promised your father I'd watch over your family, and look how I failed.
Okay, we got two people, and one, two, three things. First, let me check the teapot, or the hot chocolate pot. An ornate silver pot on tray with four porcelain cups. Each bears a Japanese-style design. One cup full of cold cocoa. Others contain dregs. A snuff box. An elegant Japanese snuff box. Inscribed with the name Georges Villiers Segonzac. Sorry, that's rude. A letter to Pierre. A note apparently to Pierre from his mother, Valerie. Left on a table. My son, I write to caution and admonish you as to your conduct. I appreciate that since the death of your father, you have enjoyed considerable financial freedom due to his foolishly generous bequest as regards yourself. Whereas I have had to make do with a pittance. Your aunt Amelie recently discovered a document that makes it quite clear that it is I that should have obtained control of my family's fortune upon the death of your father, despite the ludicrous claims of our doddering executor, I believe is how it's pronounced, who squanders our money in his foolish business dealings with the Orient. You simply must quell your extravagances, especially in regards to the vulture-like woman you consort with, in view of the fact that I will shortly obtain, control of the entire inheritance. Whatever debts you have incurred will thereupon be yours and yours only. Don't delude yourself that Amelie will come to your rescue, despite the fact that you have been foolishly generous to her. The money comes to me. She will have a small maintenance and can continue to wear mother's worthless jewelry. She does not understand the value of money, and the less of it, the better for her. Something, 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 bullshit rich people.
Yes, she threatened me. She made baseless threats at every dinner party. But she was getting angrier and angrier. So I repaired to the terrace with my brandy. On my way back down, I encountered Amelie. She sent me out to the garden to calm her sister with some hot chocolate.
Hmm.
My mother was often difficult, and she was particularly nasty this evening. I suspect it had to do with a letter she received earlier in the day. In any case, she became angrier.
Yeah, I'm just going to stand really close to this guy while he tells me his story.
I told Lucille to take her a calming cup of hot chocolate, but Aunt Amelie, fearing Lucille would upset Mother even further, took the cup away. Mother's always been unhappy that I inherited most of Father's wealth, and she often accused Lucille of wanting only my money. But that's all over now, isn't it? Lucille and I can marry at last.
No, I don't think you can. Because I think other things will prevent that. Okay, we have one more location to visit. Visit the terrace. Yep, terrace. Yep, so just her. Okay.
We got along very well. Oh, she was a bit concerned about her son being younger than me, I suppose. But I've known her since before her husband died. Poor man took ill and asphyxiated. Shame. He did manage to put Georges in charge of the family finances. My, that made Valerie furious. Very amusing. Tonight she seemed especially angry. She's never threatened Georges with execution before. Oh well, takes all kinds.
Kitty. I think I'm pretty sure I know who it is. But I'm gonna double check this. So, based off of all of this information, yeah, I think I'm pretty sure it's Amelie. Took after their ancestor, their mother, or whomever.
If you must know, I am Amelie Monvoisin. This is, was, my elder sister, Valerie Duclos. I refuse to believe that Georges poisoned her, even after what she said. Damn you! Interfering where you're not wanted. Valerie didn't deserve that money. I did much more for the honor of the family. She was nothing but a vile, hectoring drunk.
Yeah, but murder is murder.
You. If I were you, I'd be careful what I drank.
Don't worry, I'm an assassin. I've built up poison tolerance. Okay. Asshole, wake up.
I love a hot chocolate myself. I believe I'll have one now. Meanwhile, see if there's something you want.
Oh, wrong button. Alright, next. End of science. All right, the hand of science goes, takes me down to where? Good. here. Yeah. Doobie doo bop 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 dee 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 dee. Oops. I hope it's a business that. Professor Simon Marcel is bloody and badly burnt on the face and hands. Shards of glass have splintered into his face. Lionel received a near-perfect score on his chemistry exam. The exam of Lionel Viola. Viola. Bloody Bible. A Bible from the Church of Saint Colme, I'm assuming. At that address, it has a bloody handprint on its front page and is... and an inscription scrolled inside. Repent now, monsieur. Monsieur. Oh my god. Monsieur Marcel, repent while you still grace this earth. The exam of Pierre Simeoni. Pierre has failed his chemistry exam. A note has been written hastily at the bottom. We shall discuss this for the last time. Failure is not an option. Come speak to me. A trail of blood. A blood trail. It looks to have dried to a dark brown. Hey guys, what's up?
Shocked. He was quite meticulous, but he'd even give me lessons last night. Professor Marcel was cold, but kind man at heart.
I couldn't stand Professor Marcel. He was so strict. I'm sure his office mate, Professor Frisson, is happy he's dead. I know he is.
Well. Well. Careful, Arno. Chat?
To tell you the truth, I'd often hear Professor Marcel and Father Carriveau arguing in the street. I did notice the professor was working quite late on my walk home past the school. The candles from his office were lit.
He knew before the devil and learned the price of his blasphemous teachings. He and his students denouncing our Lord and questioning our holiest truths.
No, I shouldn't do that. But I will kill these fuckers. Okay. Professor Marcel, he was so strict. I'm sure his office mate, Professor Frisson, is happy he's dead. I know he is. A lesson plan. Today's experiment, mixing sulfuric acid with ethanol to produce diethyl ether, a fascinating and useful compound used as anesthetic by field surgeons. Important, caution students to never mix nitric acid with ethanol. Stress that an explosion will result. So it sounds like that's what somebody did.
Could be. Hello? Professor Marcel's experiment went wrong. Just look at that mess. Such a shame. He was a good man. Always made sure to clean up after himself. Not sure how he roomed upstairs with that filthy Professor Frisson. That man was raised in a barn.
Smashed bottles. An explosion shattered these bottles. A water bottle. Tables covered in vials filled with a variety of chemicals. They are all neatly labeled as either ethanol or sulfuric acid. Oh, they missed a quotation mark on that. I don't know if you guys can see it. Yeah, you can, right? Right there. Ethanol or sulfuric acid. They have a quotation mark after acid, but you can't see it because my camera's in the way. But they don't have one at the start of sulfuric. Anyway. Except the largest bottle of sulfuric acid, whose label is crudely placed and peeling. Sounds like somebody tampered with the bottles. I bet one of those is nitric acid. Hello, sir.
As a fellow member of the faculty, I'm devastated. As a friend, heartbroken. Professor Marcel and I roomed together for several years. We shared our offices. Of course, we had our differences, but I'm in complete shock.
You don't sound like someone in shock, but it could just be a choice. Blow up here. A key to the bedroom. A key with a tag that says office. Lavent Journal. Sorry, I butchered that. A journal containing an essay by Professor Marcel in support of the findings of Antoine Laurent de Lavoisier, if I can enunciate, against the... against the phlogiston theory of combustion. It looks as though he disputes the recent findings of Professor Frison, who does support that theory. Interesting. Not trod on the dead body. Scrap of paper. The word sulfuric acid has been handwritten in a variety of styles. Mm-hmm. list of chemicals, a handwritten list of chemicals that look to be part of the lesson plan for the day. Muriatic acid, sulfuric acid, precision scale, and glass vial. Sulfuric acid is circled. Manifesto. A manifesto written by Professor Marcel. It begins. As a youth, I may have been immune to logic, continuing to follow the church as a blind sheep to slaughter. But with age, the hand of science reached to me and freed me from perpetual ignorance. One second, sir.
Bientôt tout ton temps à la Madeleine, vipère.
All right, so yeah, it very much sounds and looks like Frisson is the guilty party, and if I remember correctly, you are Frisson.
Faculty, I'm devastated.
Yes.
As a friend, heartbroken. Professor, the man was a coward who'd taken it upon himself to ruin my career. I'm glad he's gone. The years I've spent on my research wasted. All wasted.
No false accusation.
Quite the experiment, wasn't it? Best not to mess with chemicals, I think. Pick a weapon. I can't help you. Christ.
Alright, a bug keeps taunting me. let's see here. Let's look at some of these gear, these weapons that I've gotten. Do we have any long-handed ones that... because the only ones, yeah, I want that one or that one. That one, this one requires going into the DLC, and this one is from a mission that has yet not yet happened, and so it'll either be either the Cinquedia or the Schiavona. Both of whose names I've recently learned how to pronounce thanks to a show on the History Channel I've been watching called Forged in Fire. How about down here? Anything? Okay. So I've only got these two, it looks like. That are gold. Even that one's not linked gold. Okay. Heavy. Any heavy ones that are gold? That one is the Officer's Bardiche. And the Great Flamberge is not. I like the heavy falchion more, though, for that. And of course there's these, and that's it, because this is not, yep, okay, and only the one. Wait, this is, oh, melee is not, that's right, and I can't get these until DLC, okay, so yeah, we've been getting a lot of low level weapons basically. Alright, next, progress tracker. Yeah. Captated Walden is located in the Oh, interesting. It's down here. Right about looks to be here. Ooh, that's grisly. Dissolving corpse in the tannery. Come on. The body of an unidentifiable man dissolving in a tub of acid. The head has been chopped off cleanly, and there's a stab wound to the chest. It is unusual as the puncture bears the marks. The mark of an X. On his finger, so basically the blade does has this kind of a shape to it, or even this kind of a shape, kind of like a T shape. On his finger sits an ornate gold ring. The address of the maker is etched on the inner shank. Well, said skank. That's a completely different thing. All right. Talk to the witness.
Finally get a vacation, only to find a headless corpse rotting in my tannery. That thing's been sitting here at least a few days. But the wound on his chest. Only a custom blade could do that. I've heard rumors those awful gangs love to leave their mark on their victims.
Are you a short sword, a custom crafted short sword, likely the murder weapon? The quillon has been forged into an X, explaining the strange puncture wound left on the body. There is a maker's mark with the address of a blacksmith. Okay, that's 3 out of 4. Where is 4 out of 4? Right there. Hello, sir.
A few days ago, I heard some strange noises outside my window late in the night. When I looked outside, I saw someone going into the tannery carrying something quite large. I just assumed it was Citizen Gilbert, working late as always. I had no clue he was vacationing and someone broke in. Otherwise, I'd have told someone.
I mean, fair. That is a fair assumption if you didn't know. All right. Okay. So we have 2 other locations to go to. We'll go, let's go to this one first. Learn about the murder weapon. We'll learn about this first.
Oh, this ring.
How could I not recognize my own masterpiece? Of course, it belongs to Warden LaRue. You must return this. I'm sure he'll be looking for it. You'll find him working at the prison at La Salpêtrière, or home with his wife, Madame Camille. I'll write down the address for you.
Oh my god, I just realized. I was like, what the hell? How did I throw the thing? My hand wasn't even on the keyboard. I have this plugged in and charging. And I accidentally bumped. I moved it and pushed one of the buttons, and that caused Arno to do the thing. Oh, that's funny. Okay, okay, so I talked to him because we were here. So we're going over here. Because it's on the way.
If the blade left the mark of an X, well, that's one of mine. I forge him custom for the Ganglay Marcher Law. It stands for X marks the spot or some such thing. Bearded fella, much like yourself, purchased one of those blades a few days ago.
Much like myself,
I
huh?
I can't be responsible for these once they're sold. Check the tavern, Le Creux. It's where les Marcher Law spend most of their time. I'll write down the address for you.
All right, so we've been here, we've been here. We have not been here. That's the prison where he works. Tavern and the warden's house. We'll go to the tavern first because there's only two clues there. Arno man. Ha! Actually, no, hold on. Dorian. Da 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 da, Dorian. Stabby stab. Watch out! It's the Dorian. Come on, through the door. There you go.
I was expecting someone to come by and pin LaRue's death on us. Sure, the warden had some debt. But we were negotiating the release of some of my men in return. Why would I toss away a deal like that? I'm not a fool.
That's very valid. Unless somebody under this man's command got hasty. I'm missing a clue. Ah, down there. That would do it.
Say nothing. I just serve Le Marcher Mort their ale and carry about me business. You can take it up with their leader upstairs.
Already did. Okay. Okay. To the warden's house. Thank you. not dumb.
He deserved better than this. He had his faults, but he was a good man. Not that his wife even cares. Such fake tears. Always running off with a new man.
Hey, Queen. Good to see you. Good to see you. Glad you could make it. We're working on some murder mysteries.
My husband had many enemies. Running a prison made sure of that. I must admit, he'd been missing 2 nights before I could bring myself to tell the police. It's no secret that I wasn't faithful, but I would never do such a horrible thing.
Me? Well, I'm here to console Madame Camille, that's all. Just a friend.
Mm-hmm. That's all, sure. Mm-hmm. Console. Mm-hmm. Console. Warden's house. Letter from Warden Leroux. Letter from Lord Leroux to Citizen General Security Officer. Dear sir, I must inform you of my desire to remove Hugo Solier from his post as deputy warden. In the past months, he has shown both an insubordinate attitude and a reckless disregard for the management of our prisoners. Under his watch, in the last week, we've had 2 attempted escapes and several altercations arise between prisoners. Please advise. Sincerely, Warden Leroux. Letter from Julien to Madame Camille. My love, I must profess, I still count the days till we can meet again. But with Monsieur Leroux, insatiable paranoia, I fear this day may never come. Each breath he takes tightens the chains that imprison our love. Eternally yours, Julien Lamont. Wasn't that this guy? Who are you?
Me? Well, I'm here to console Madame Camille, that's all.
Yes. So, yes, he gets to have the privilege of her now that Leroux is dead. I'm missing something. Is it the paper up there? Is it you? No, that's La Patriot. Hold on a second, that would be so fucking hilarious if my audio hadn't come through, wasn't coming through this whole time. Alright. Ah! Aha! Hello. Madame? Mademoiselle?
I knew something was wrong. Warden Leroux was always home late, but for him to simply vanish for 2 days made no sense. I heard he'd been mixed up with Les Marcheurs Morts, that horrible gang, but I honestly thought it was just rumors.
Okay. We know the gang didn't do it, even though he owed the gang money. The gang didn't do it, even though he owed him money. They would have never gotten what they wanted in exchange. But whoever did kill him is trying to make it look like they did it. So we're down to either Julien Lamont, people who have motive. Julien Lamont, which is this guy, the lover of the warden's wife, and the deputy, the deputy warden, the deputy warden, because he was trying to get the deputy warden fired. We'll see what. So that takes us to the jail, the prison here. So let's see what we can find up here. Dorian. 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 Oh, it's a prison. Of course they won't let me just climb the fence. Duh.
He doesn't know what he's doing.
There's another murder over there, though. That's good to know.
Warden LaRue's head placed on a pike for all in the prison to see. Surely a message to me who must follow his brave tenure. I'd wished him a good night just yesterday. I'd heard rumors of his gambling debts with Les Marcheurs Morts, that wretched gang.
It's absolutely the deputy warden. Nah.
The horror, the gore
nah.
of these
Hate
vermin.
You.
Hate Look,
you.
Accuse me, but I'm in charge of the prison you'd like to throw me in. The irony of being locked up here. Are you enjoying this? Are you?
A little bit.
I was certain the wife did it. She knows the town a little too well, if you know what I mean. Take your pick.
No false accusations. That voice actor did such a good job. Ooh, Gladius. Take a look-see at the Gladius, shall we? Weapons, one-handed. Gladius. It's probably like really high up here. There it is. Yep. A gladius. Roman gladius. Okay. So how many of these do we have left? Only one, right? Yeah. Cut the middleman. And that, I believe, was the one we found that we actually stumbled across down here. Yeah.
Honor, Godspeed.
Probablement un voleur qui fuit les gardes.
Oh. Oh, it's also in the prison. Interesting. Kitty. The body is dismembered. These cuts are precise, surgical. There is not much blood, but plenty of sand in the wounds. A fishhook was left attached to the flesh, and the skin is covered in puncture wounds. Seaweed. The same algae that grows in the River Seine. Whatever. It's also covered in sand. A small satchel that contains bait, hooks, and fishing line. It also contains a ripped up proof of, oh my god, a ripped proof of release document stamped by officials at La Salpêtrière, the asylum next door. The name of who was released is illegible. Heavy set of footprints.
Citizen, hold there!
Those papers are for a patient we just released. You always blabbered on about being a fisherman, so your best bet is to check the river. We also had a patient escape a few weeks ago. You can check their cells inside, just down the steps.
Oh boy. Filled with circled drawings and a book, Guide to Fish Species. Filled with circled drawings and descriptions of various types of fish. Well worn and looks to have been read a thousand times. Mattress. A fishing hook. Disgusting. Hidden under the bed is a dead rat impaled multiple times by a fishing hook. Disgusting. Alright, let's see what his neighbor has to say.
What happened? I had a paper cut, but my whole arm got infected because it's so filthy in here. Some surgeon thought he had the right to hack it clean off. The pain almost killed me.
Torn medical journals. Pages from a torn up medical journal belonging to a surgeon named Dr. Leonard Ernie. It is filled with drawings of the human anatomy and surgical procedures. It also has a large list of patients and their addresses. All but one has been crossed off. A patient named Charlotte Doiron, whatever. Who lives at 9 blah blah blah. There is also a return address for the surgeon at that address. Both addresses would be worth a visit. Okie day. We have gates. Okay. Gates. Office. Shack, dock, house. Let us go to the dock first. That's where we found corpse, stuff connected to the corpse. So maybe it's where the body was found or originally affected.
Citizen, stop!
Don't worry about me. We got more important things to worry about.
I was fishing a few days ago and I found a body floating in the river. Cut up arms and legs too. It must have floated here from upstream. I didn't know what to do with it, so I took it to the cemetery. I'm sorry.
Aw. Human limb is evidently, looks to be female. There are fresh scratches on the wrist. Okay. Alright, let's go check out this shack from upriver. Born journal. The pages belong to a surgeon's journal. They show diagrams of the human anatomy. Several names of patients are crossed out. Could be potential murder victims. Leather straps. These look like the kind of leather straps worn to control a prisoner or a patient. They are caked in dried blood. A large and very sharp cleaver could be part of the set. Pile of corpses. Corpses look like they have been sitting here for at least a week. They were hacked to pieces and are now impossible to identify. Okay. Office. House. Office first. Only got the two.
My journal. Proof my assistant is taking jobs behind my back. He's always late.
Excuse me.
God knows what. I don't care how good he is with Blade. I can't trust a man who's stealing clients. Best to let him go.
Don't. I'm not sure that's what he's doing. But I shall let you know once my investigation has completed.
What can I say? My boss is a good barber, but a horrible surgeon. I was using his clients to make a little money on the side. Cut out the middleman.
Jamais
Please, help. My wife is missing. She'd just come home from the butcher, but when I went into the bedroom upstairs, she was gone, and there's blood everywhere. I think it's hers. Please, help me.
Poor guy. Oh god, that is a lot of blood. There's blood all over the house. It is unlikely the wife is alive. It looks like the body was dragged and then bagged up to carry. Signs of struggle. His wife put up quite a fight. Her attacker looks to have had a lot of trouble with her, as the house is a mess. Raw meat. Uncooked meat from a butcher shop. Looks like it hasn't been out very long. The shop must be nearby. One, two, three, four, five. This is the last one, probably. Yeah. Butcher's knives. Butcher's knives, they look to be part of a set, though a large cleaver is missing. Maybe like the one we found by the river. With all the corpses.
Murders? Well, some crazy man came by here rambling about a corpse. That's all I know. How about some fresh pork? My assistant can give you a perfect cut. He's a little slow in the head. Came in here a few weeks ago begging for work, but I tell you, the boy has a gift. A gift that finally leaves me some time to get some fishing in.
I just want to work. I won't bother no one. What do you want? I must work. I just want to work. I won't bother no one. What do you want? I must work.
I have a pit in my stomach, so I think I know where they're going to go with this. But let's check my evidence to make sure it's not what I'm worried it is. Okay, so the dead man whose body they found was the one who was released, which means the one who escaped is the one who did it, probably, and it's gonna, we'll just try it.
Let me cut meat. There was so much to cut, so little time. So much meat left to cut. Can't stop. Never stop.
Yeah, it's some Victor Zsasz stuff.
Where's Vidocq?
Little beast broke out again. Don't you worry. I'll catch up with him soon enough. He's not that bright. Expect to see him on the gallows one of these fine days. Horrible. That's the last time I fish in those waters. Have a look and see which weapon suits you.
Yep. All right. That's all the murder mysteries. Okay. That's from my list. How are we doing on time? 8:49? Okay, yeah, we're good. Okay, next is, oops. This one. Oh, nope. Cancel that. We'll start this, then I'm gonna pause, and then and run to the bathroom. And we'll take a bit of a break. Yeah! It was a good murder mysteries. We completed them all, though, so now we're moving on to other things. But I'm glad you could make it.
I've decided, so good, child, that you to away. Hear your confession.
Thank you, Father. As I protect you on Earth, may you protect me in the afterlife.
You think you protect me? Who will protect you?
That's Jack Rue, basically the angriest priest in history.
Kill the food hoarders!
He was extreme, too extreme for Robespierre even. As bad as the Reign of Terror was, Rue would have taken things to a whole new level. Templars kept Rue in their back pocket for when Robespierre fell.
I'm running out of guards, Rue.
Those assassins will be coming back for me.
We're counting on it. Stretch your legs. Tomorrow you lead the Terror in a new direction.
Make sure your masters hold up their end of the bargain.
They always do.
Some assassins already failed once trying to kill Rue. We think they were captured. Find them, and then finish the job.
Will do. All right, so I'm gonna quickly step away for a bit. I have to run to the bathroom. And when I get back, we will do this mission. Don't go anywhere, y'all. We'll be right back. Okay, I am back. Let's get into this, shall we? Okay.
If the assassins are alive, they never left the asylum. Check the list of prisoners and try to find them.
Come on, no. There we go. Alright.
Hey! Stay there, citizen! Where are you going? I want to play too!
You don't get to play. Alright. Loot the corpse. Steal his vest! Okay. There, those there. Climb. Yes. This looks like I can climb. I cannot climb. Okay, that's fine. All right, we'll go over here first. Come on. There you go. Ooh, maybe underground access. Is it up? Up. Yes, it's up. It's up. Okay. Okily dokily. We're on the roof. On the roof. We are on the roof. Okay. One. Out of four. Okay, so we've three more to find. We know where one is. Also on the roof. Unless it's down inside. Oh, it might be inside. In fact, I think it is inside. I think that's it right there. Okay. I wonder if it's over here. They like to do that. Too far. Yep, there it is. I wondered. Interesting. Okay, hold on. Let us mark this. But we don't forget about it. Excuse me, sir. I didn't mean to bump into you. I'm just trying to figure out a way underground. Is there a door? No. Not an easy one, at least. Okay. Get off the geometry, Arno. Be a way down here. Over here, maybe? Hey, fellas. Don't mind me. Just passing through.
Get over here! I'll finish you quick if you ask me.
Get off the geometry, dude. Alright. Yeah, I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna try these, whatever this is, stairs, ladder, whatever. Okay. I still have the I do not, okay. Move at 10, right? Oops, wrong thing. No, it wasn't that I wanted. It was that. There we go. Now we have you. Okay. Come on, Arno, go in, dude. Dude, for real? There you go. Well now. Oh, our objective's over here. What's in here? What does this button do? Oh, it just takes me back to where I was. Okay. Yeah, because there's that. Okay, and then I came through here. Right. Okay. Interesting.
Hey, you! Stay there a moment!
Oh, shit!
Here you are! Was that a wasp? Felt like...
Nothing?
Red!
Wellity, wellity, wellity. Okay.
If the assassins are alive, they never left the asylum. Check the list of prisoners and try to find them.
Okay, so I did already get those. I need to go over here. Okay.
Stop there, citizen!
Hi. Die. They're fighting, so I'm just gonna quickly pop over here, do this, and then climb. And up one more. Do up. Bop bop dee 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 crunch dee 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 crunch dee 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 dee. Put the sword away. It was a mistake. I didn't mean to. Ignore me. There's a thing below me, okay.
Looks like the assassins are still alive, and they're being held in the prison. You want to free them before things get too crazy.
We'd love to give you a grip. There's you, citizen. Aha! Oh, dead. Where are you?
Like this one bit. Andre.
Where is he, Mokiti?
Now we go into that sewer area. Apparently Yvonne's stream went down too. Interesting.
Aurait-il perdu l'esprit?
Nothing.
My feet. They're growing.
My feet. They're growing. I love it. Make sure I don't forget it. Regrets and mistakes.
Here with you.
Hang out here for a second. Ba-da-dum, ba-dum, ba-dum.
Hold it, you!
Ba-da-da-da-dum.
way! You have stayed your welcome, so piss off!
Aha, bastard!
Yo, ho, oh, hun.
Halt, citizen!
So slow! You're like molasses!
Ah, that's the door I want. Fight! 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 Come on. Okay, so he just won. And now he will fall over from death because there's nobody else for him to kill for a bit in a minute. All right, now let's free one of our captive assassins.
Brother, over here. Free me, please.
Okay, initiate. I love that he just vanished. Assassin free.
Hey, Yvonne B with the raid. 1 second. Let me finish this. We had trauma! Yay! Trauma! That's not much better than what we've had. We've had some murder mysteries, which involved some trauma! Though not as much, probably, as what you've been dealing with. I'm currently working to free some assassins who had been captured by Templars and put in an insane asylum. Yeah. Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. let's see here. Let's see if I can remember this. Shout out Eve on
B.
Does it work? Hey, I think it worked. Maybe. I guess. Hey, whatever. Anyway, hi! Hope you all had a good trauma stream with Yvonne. Thank you for the raid, Yvonne. Thank you all for coming in. If you aren't familiar with me, I am Crimson Knight. I do the weird shit, and I bug the hell out of Yvonne. My schedule is pretty boring and usual and steady and usual. Mondays we do Assassin's Creed. Tuesdays we wear pink. No, wait, what's the quote? Is it Wednesdays we wear pink? God, whatever. Anyway, Wednesdays we wear pink, right? Okay. Tuesdays is Tomb Raider Tuesday. Wednesdays are Watch Dogs Wednesday. excuse me for the cough. And Fridays I play whatever I'm late to the bandwagon on. recently on Fridays I've been playing ReCore, which is pretty great. My usual schedule, my usual time is 7 p.m. to 7 p.m. Central ish. Hi. If you wanna learn more about me, I have a link tree which has links of, or you can, places where you can follow me, and links where you can support me if you so choose. If not, fine. Let me actually come back here and. Oh, he stopped streaming too. Okay, fair. Okay, so we're just gonna close that. So anyway, hi everybody. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the madness. I did notice earlier, Yvonne, because I had your stream up in that on my screen back here. I had your stream up. I did notice that you lost connection. Was that why you decided to end the stream? Or were you guys actually at a point where you were done? Murder!
Get back to work! Just rest in a
moment. Are you rude? Processing trauma and talking about ending and then lost connection. Okay, so it was well timed. And then we processed trauma more. And then you raided me! Then you handed your followers off to me for more trauma. Seemed appropriate. Well, we all know, anybody who knows me knows that I traumatize everybody around me, so it works. But also beyond that, Moida! Murder! Well, I'm gonna let them finish their fight and go this way. Rude! That guy was just sleeping against the wall and the guy just rushes over to him and starts wailing on him with a sword. Alright, we'll come back. Let's go check on the other group. What progress has been made? Oh. Okay, fine. Alright, we're gonna do that. And that. Because I'm tired of waiting. And we're gonna do that. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Later!
Is that you?
It is.
Quickly, unlock my cell.
And I'm not technically an assassin anymore, which is, this is probably one of the missions why I become one again. Oh God, what was it I was watching that had the thickest New York accents in it? I was watching something earlier today that just had the thickest New York accents. And it's an ad break. That's fine.
Brother, free me. Unlock my cell and I can aid you.
Okay, all the assassins are freed. You're clear to take out Rue. You just need to find him.
Sir, are you feeling a little off kilter?
There he is. Looks like he's making the rounds before he leaves the grounds. Get him before he makes it to his carriage. You've been spotted. Run for the carriage. Get him, quickly.
You know what? No. I'm a cheese it a bit. Okay, real quick. Let me check. Okay.
Okay, all the assassins are freed. You're clear to take out Rue. You just need to find him. There's Rue. Looks like he's making the rounds before he leaves the grounds. Get him before he makes it to his carriage. Looks like Rue's collecting some cash from his enragé. This might be a good chance to take him out.
We've been waiting eagerly for your return, Father.
Everything ran smoothly while I was gone.
Smoothly?
So smoothly. Then what is this I hear about money going missing? You two wouldn't know anything about that. Would you?
No. Never, Jacques.
I just couldn't bear it if I found out. You two stole from me. You're like sons to me.
We did everything we could to keep the business running.
When I met you both, you were street urchins. I trusted you, clothed you. Look at you now.
All of the money is there, Father. Down to the sou.
Good. Glad I can count on you two.
Thank you, Father.
Rue's moving on. Look for another window to open up.
All right,
Rue is dead. Now get out of there.
Stuck any royalists like these, huh?
Oh, God. mind me, just running through my own poison cloud. It's fine. Come on, Arno. Walk it off. Walk it off, dude. Wait, Yvonne, right before the ad break, I was actually starting to say something.
The Templars just lost another weapon in the fight for the
revolution. I was starting to say that, I was starting to say that I had, recently, like this morning, was watching something that had, like, the thickest of thick, New York accents. I don't remember what it was, but, like, every time somebody opened their mouth, I was just like, I'm not sure whether this is accurate or whether it whether Yvonne would consider this to be a hate crime. but it was funny. Ruse remains. All right. I believe is a social club. Yep, that one right there.
Not a bad take.
Okay. Now then. Oh, there we go. That's the one. And the other one is an engaging Egyptologist. Ah, it's one of those. Okay. Okay. All right. Do 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 do. All right. Stairs. Down. I want up. Away so I can read the thing, please. Enragé, l'Enragé were a loose amalgam of extremist radicals. They were led by Jacques Roux, who famously incited food riots. Assassinate one of Jacques Roux's lieutenants, preaching to a crowd of sans whatever in the courtyard of Hôtel de Cluny. So basically, now that we've killed their leader, we have to remove the rest of the infection. How about you stop insulting, assaulting people in the middle of the street, my dude? Alright, let me refill my shit. Alright. Arno Torian Arno Oh, hi. Where did you two come from? Holy shit. Fucking go away. Uh-oh. Stop it.
Stop it!
You coward! Crikey! That's no good.
God dang. Alright. No, I don't think I will. Not that. That. There we go. Vicious Verses. Right there. I write the political satire aimed directly at him. Famous paint Jacques-Louis David has called in favors. I think that's supposed to be famous painter. In favors from Robespierre and his supporters to put an end to these satirical attacks. Writer André Chenier has been targeted by a personal vendetta and cannot return to his home to secure the final verses of his satire. Obtain the poems for him. Okay. All right, so it's that way. Puts it, if that is north, southeast, west of me, west and south. Is it this one? Yes. Okay, now. This is closer.
You there? Are you the muse to answer my call? The pleadings of a poet with the honor of France in his heart? Say the name Jacques-Louis David and see if you don't gag on the sound. Well, I have written a series of poems satirizing the life of that most despicable propagandist. Sadly, the final verses are under lock and key in my abode. If you could retrieve them, the people of France would learn the truth about David and his confabulations. And my legacy would be assured.
Hey, Matt, thanks for the lurk.
Go.
What? Politicians threatening satirists? Never.
Thank you.
That's a lot of red.
It has me laughing. It really does. You'll laugh too when your head falls in a bucket.
In these we should worry about colorful metaphors, trenchant hyperbole, that sort of thing. All the sort of rubbish the overeducated adore.
We're looking to kill a man over a few metaphors.
As good as any other given reason these days.
C'est vrai, c'est vrai.
Jesus, you need a good bleeding. Obviously some ill humors in you.
Wardrobe. Must wardrobe!
I love that the guy on the outside is trying to fire through a solid wall, by which I mean through a glass window, but is one that registers as a solid wall. You can't break those, let alone shoot through them. Wow, the reinforcements just keep coming. Shit. Let's just eat. Oh, I missed. Fuck, I missed again. Oh, he dead. He dead.
Sounded like gunfire.
Someone shoot him.
Nope, that wasn't gunfire.
Wait a minute.
Damn!
Someone got Michelle.
Good.
One of ours. Christ.
Alright. Who the hell did this?
Bastard. You're mine, corpse. That
shit.
Sounded like gunfire.
Where?
That was...
Landry.
No
one through here, you bastard. Something's going on.
Hey,
sitter!
Got
him!
I mean, that was one way to clear them all out. Probably not the way I would have chosen per- oh, damn it, Arno. Probably not the way I would have chosen it personally, but you know. C'est la vie. I guess technically it was also in a assassin-y way of doing things. Technically. Excuse me.
Bravo, mon ami, bravo! Now all of France may hear the conclusion of Le Jeu de Paume and see the true hues that color Jacques-Louis David. Oh, they'll lose their heads with laughter, I guarantee.
All right. Now, I need, before we do the next thing, I need to do a couple of things. I need to pop over here.
Sleep well, sir.
Yeah, well. Ooh, only 9 seconds. Or 8 seconds, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Income? All right.
Ah, Celestine, there you are. I
wonder if I... Now.
General Thoreau is meeting with some modest success in much of the countryside.
Nearest. Don't mind me. I know I'm technically exiled, but I'm just popping in here to refill some stuff. Don't mind me. I'm on my way.
Hello, my friend.
A word?
Alright, so next on the list is... Is it here? Yes. Oh, I didn't want to do that. The good news is that because of the fact that I don't have to worry about money anymore, because I've gotten the best equipment that I can get and all of that.
That's La Madeleine, one of Paris's many churches.
I don't have to worry about trying to get the best
amount of money. Under construction, meaning it's closed. But we've spotted the Templars going in and out of the building. Seems they found a first civilization site underneath the church, and the artifacts are being hidden in these houses. You need to get the artifacts. Time to mix it up with some training. Which treasure is the right one? You need to find it, then get the goods.
Wait a second. Okay, so yeah, I don't have to worry about any pickups. Just complete the mission. Oh boy.
Right.
I've officially become an assassin because of my assassin rank. Yay. Okay. The unfortunate thing is, to my knowledge, there is no way of being able to tell which of these is real and which of them is fake. You just guess and hope. For the love of.
You can't hide, maggot!
Yes, I can. I'm doing it.
Aha, bastard! You can't escape, maggot!
To find a way in, I would like to find a way
real
in.
Real patriots, and now for the fun bit. Stop this! Tony made a big mistake trying to outrun
God, I would love to have a way in.
Halt, citizen!
There's a way in, finally. Investigate. Or go kill your friend. One of the two.
Something.
Just to help him out a little bit. There we go. They say shit. Hi.
Dream that.
Jesus. Where did it get?
What? You don't look so good today. You look like stop you.
Stop yes. You right there.
Okay, while they're fighting, I'm gonna come over here. And open this. Bishop, I love you. Wah, wah.
What was that? Huh? 30 pike off to.
Graham, what's happened?
This guy's just like, that's not my problem. Please. 10 o'clock, please be the right one.
Nothing in this one.
Okay. Alright, so we've got two more and... Okay, we're gonna stop by this guy. If I can.
Nice try!
in your tracks.
What the devil's?
Hey, you!
Stay there a moment! Wasp!
Oh, please!
I'm not hearing
then.
This better not be a sodding joke. That's odd. Hold a moment. Son of a... Bloody hell! Marku! On this.
Is that correct?
Yeah, that's a fake. Sorry.
Wah, wah. Is there another one in here? No, there's one more. Okay. There's only one more and it's not in here. Got it. Okay. Okay. Now there's a fight happening outside, and I'm okay with that. Because I'm going to come over here and just pop, pop. And I'll just walk and steal. There we go. That's gotta be it, because it was the last one.
That's it. Good work.
Oh, right, I have to escape there. And let's... buy our shit first.
Content de vous voir ici.
All right. All righty then. A very decent bit of progress here. We completed all of the murder mysteries. Brought our total sync up to 86%. We completed the last of the heist missions. And yeah, we just have a few more co-op missions. Let's see here. How many more things do we have? Until we can get back on the see here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We only have 6 more things until we can get back into the until we're able to get back into the main storyline. And yeah, so what we have left is we have those 6 things I just mentioned, and then we have 3 chapters of the main storyline, and then we're done with the main storyline. And then we have another co-op, and then another Paris stories. And then we have technically the start of the DLC. However, before we do any of that with any of the DLC, I want to complete all the other side quests. Even though the DLC takes place before some of these missions. So like we have the Desiree series of missions, which take place in 1795, and whereas the DLC takes place approximately 1794, and all of that takes place before the final scene that we'll get at the end of the main storyline. So yeah. Before we get to the DLC, I want to do the other side missions. Well, maybe. We'll see. I'll play it by ear. But yeah, we're getting close to the end of Assassin's Creed Unity. So we're making progress. All right. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks again to Yvonne for the raid. Oh, and we're in the middle of an ad. It's fine. We'll wait for the ad and then I'll do my outro. Actually, while I'm waiting, is there anybody I want to raid? That's a very good question. I have a decent number of people. Who should I should pass on the raid I got. Ooh. Hey, he's playing Fortnite. Yeah, I might do that. Yeah, what we're gonna do is pop on a raid. I can spell his name right. actually, while we're waiting on that ad to wrap up, I'm gonna pop over here, which will be done in like 30 seconds. I'm gonna pop back to here, and we're gonna take a bit of a tour, because it's been a minute. Pick up some money. All right, welcome back from the ad break. I was about to start wrapping up when I realized you guys were in the middle of an ad, so I decided to wait. Before I've gotten a couple more mementos and stuff, so we're gonna just take a quick. Ooh, it's actually pretty dark in here. Take some tours, you know. But actually. I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up there. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks to again to Yvonne B for the raid. You can check her and Melador out, and as I have several other recommendations up here. I have even more recommendations in that link tree below. Please stick around. We will be raiding Cat-like Thief Official in a bit. He's playing some Fortnite. But before we do that, I got that link tree I want to talk about. In that link tree, you'll find links to where you can follow me. Places where you can hang out with me, my friends. Follow me for updates on social medias and the like. You can also support this channel and my content creation as well as my tomfoolery if you subscribe to this Patreon. There's also a throne wish list in that link tree, where you can get me awesome little things like this beautiful, PS5 controller. I blanked on what it was. I was holding it in my hand and everything. Anyway, so yeah, thanks again for tuning in. Thanks again for the raid. We'll be back tomorrow with Tomb Raider Tuesdays, assuming SAG doesn't declare a video game strike before 7 p.m. So until then, remember to have empathy, be kind, be safe, love yourselves and love everyone around you, and I'll see you all tomorrow. I love you all. Peace out.